1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Okay, students, there was a full performance with the correct hand position for Away in a Manger. And you can always rewind and look at that clip and slow it down if in the video player if you'd like as well. But I just also wanted to quickly talk about some of the hand position in Away in a Manger. And to start out, we have in the right hand finger 5 on D is our note. Okay? And the song just works down to the left. D, D, C, B, B, A, G. And this is in the second measure of our song, if we're not counting our pre-measure one as a measure. And there's a finger change that happens there. We play G, and then finger 4 moves to G. So we do G, G, and then students, that's an F sharp. And you might say, well, Mr. John, why is it an F sharp? Well, remember, there's a key signature in this song, which makes all the F sharp. See that little sharp at the very beginning of your song? It's on the line, that is the F line. And so it makes every F sharp in the song unless it tells us otherwise, okay? So we're playing F sharp and then E, D. So we're really doing 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, everything else stays pretty much the same there. We play D, D, E, D, D, A, F sharp, E, D, but then look here, this G we play at the end of the second line, you play finger 3, and then I'm using finger 5 on B for 2 beats, and then we'll release, and we go back to our D right here. Now, on the third line of the song, you play the same melodies before, D, C, B, but when we get to this B the second time, in the first line, it was just all quarter notes. But in the third line, we play B, A, G. It's a dotted half note. So it's... Then we do that finger change on G, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then D, C, B, A, B, A, G, A, E, F sharp, G. So I want you to practice playing right hand only for this song, making sure you can play it all the way through each line without any pauses. And then the left hand only. So I'm gonna play the right hand right now with the right fingering, get it to the point you can play with me and make no mistakes with fingering or notes or rhythms. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Very nice, and watch out for that line 3. Whenever, for some reason, when I move from that B to that D, I'll sometimes catch the C there. Not sure why, I did it a couple times when I tried the full performance. Okay, left hand starts out with G, B, D, 5, 3, 1, on 5 on G, okay? We do that for 6 beats, then we have the left hand for 2 beats, and then we just play G and B without the D on top. Next, you play F sharp and C for 6 beats, and then it does a C, B, C, B for 2. Now we're in the third line, still G, B, D, and then it does it again for 6 beats, and then a G and C, that's 5 and 2, back to our G and B only, and then a F sharp C, then G B D, then it goes G and C, then F sharp C D, and then G B D at the end. So here's the left hand all at once. Make sure you can do it without any pauses. One, two, three, here I go. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three. 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 One, two, off. All right, students, good luck practicing. You got this.